It was a team without much size, as we all know, but obviously they were great leapers since they all can dunk the ball. Who is Don Ross, and what did this his finest team ever think about the man who had molded them into champions? He contributed much in the way of leadership and coaching strategy while bringing them together from diverse backgrounds into a close five-man unit.
In that situation, that is why I had my head, not to see you miss a foul shot or Bob Natel throw the ball away or Barry kick it down the floor somewhere or Russell Bruce throw one up and break the glass on a backboard. That's why.
Coach, wait a minute. You said you didn't swear, but then again you said that you have to hide your head from saying vulgarity.
That's
because
right.
The people...
We're talking about the situation. He asked the question, I answered you. I said no.
But then you said shucks, darn, whatever else you said.
Coach, we all heard what you're...
But we heard, and the fans even told us they read your lips a few times on that.
Have I ever had a technical foul this year, Frank? Yes or no?
Have you, Frank?
Have you?
No.
Have you had
no.
a technical foul this year?
No.
How many, Frank?
Ask him what happened in the Farrell game up there. Bobby, would you attest to that?
Mr. Ross would like to know what happened down in the Farrell game.
We won.
Was there a technical foul call?
I think he's going for smacking the ball out of bounds.
Was it Heasley?
Oh, yeah,
maybe
Heasley.
It was Heasley. I got the wrong guy.
Yeah, it was Heasley.
Okay.
Coach Ross, tell us about the rule, Ace.
Oh, yeah. Tell us about why it's sort of a tradition on a team for you to take roll aids every game, you know, in school. You come into gym class, you see Coach Ross with his head on the table, stuffing roll aids in his mouth. We just want to know what this really does for yourself.
Hold on. I want to know if it's like eating a peppermint patty.
First of all, I've never eaten a peppermint patty. But if anyone had to work with guys like you, I think they would take roll aids the rest of their lives, not just in basketball season. A steady diet. Now, Richard Yoram doesn't say a word. He just sits here. He never says a word, never gives me any trouble. Russell Bruce never gives me any trouble. Jason sings the alma mater, sings the national anthem, never gives me any trouble. Then I got to run into Natel and Bonjovingo and Wetzel. And there's where my problems begin.
What this 1982 Newcastle High team did for its community will not be forgotten. They showed what determination can do. They rallied crowds of 5,000 people behind them, and they taught a whole state that we are NC. Barry Wetzel, Jimmy Brown, Russell Bruce, Frank Bonjovingo, Bob Natel, Paul Schweikert, Richard Yoram, Jason Rankin, and the others. They fell one step shy, perhaps, but hey, NC, in our hearts we know.
We're going to have one timeout left. Thomas inbound to basketball now. Barry Wetzel pressuring, and Thomas looking, still looking. Law pass to Barry Watts. Barry Watts in the basket now. It'll be Newcastle ball. Newcastle has the basketball. Don Ross went timeout. Oh, my. How about that one? Woo!
Here's the punch of Gringo. 3 seconds. Frank wins up the shot. Yes, God! Yes, God!
Heroes
make a scene. Here's to all brothers. Here's to all people. Here's to the miracles they make us see.